Hello everybody, Funic Arts here. This is the One Piercing Knight quest guide. This guide is the first of the fully voiced quests that were made by Jagex. Alright, this quest, you start it pretty much, you see where the You Are Here sign is. To get there, you just take the lodestone to Alcarid, head across where the desert strike worms at, or out in here, and you'll be right outside the Abbey Gates. As you'll see, I'm right here with the Strikeworm Hunter, and because this quest is fully voiced, I will not be having the voices play because they are much slower than some of the others, but I will have the music playing because it actually is pretty good music. Alright, to start this quest, the Strikeworm Hunter will talk to you. And he just warns you that it's a fully voiced quest. Once you're here at the Abbey, talk to Sister Katarina. And you'll pretty much... just say yes, you'll help her. And you'll have the accept quest thing. Head on in. Once you're inside, head to the second room on the left. Head on in and talk to Abbess Benita. She'll tell you about a murder that happened. And as she goes through explaining how it was murdered quite brutally, she'll ask you to go check Sister Anna's stuff. And to do this, you have a lot of stuff to actually do, so we'll start off with that. She hands you a notebook telling you what you need to check. As you open it, it'll say areas of investigation, examine the body, search Anna's cell, question the suspects. To start this off, we'll go ahead and examine the body. And examining the body, we run to the first room all the way on the right. And the first thing is the bed. We'll inspect the body there. You open the wrappings on the body. You note her body's been cleaned and put in burial robes. Any clues that were on her clothing has been lost. The victim's face has been horribly mutilated, and the front of the skull has been bludgeoned in, and the skin of the face has been removed. On the back of the head, you find a blunt force wound, and she was hit by a heavy object. There's three deep stab wounds in the victim's chest, one of them piercing her heart, and the feet are heavily mutilated, several toes being cut off. Also, at this time, if you would like to hear a fully voiced one, including the voice of Omustardo, RuneScape named Castle Wars, head on over to Jakir Craft's channel, and he'll have it on there. Alright, after that, we'll examine the cell. Examine the one that has been broken windowed. Head on in and inspect the bed. Under there, you'll find a fragment of clothing. Inspect the window. And you'll find that it's been broken from the inside. Once you do that, head on down here to the very far northwest room, or the first room on the left as you enter the Abbey. Once you get in there, examine one of the beds. Examine this first bed here. And you'll find another piece of cloth. Once you do that, you'll have to question suspects. We'll go ahead and start by talking to Sister Elena. And there's three clues from her. Ask what you're cooking. I just go through all the chat options to make it quick. What'd you think of Sister Anna? And then ask what she was about the troubadour outside. Or troubadour. However Jagex does that. Once you do that, you can head on, go ahead and head further north, open the door, and head on up these stairs. We'll go ahead and get the sister upstairs. One more and you'll see that there is some feet sticking up. As you see, there's feet down here. Can't hear me, so. And she asks you to set the time. So on the other side, you'll see operate clock mechanism. You'll find that the clock is 20 minutes fast. Ah. She says the clock is 20 minutes fast, but it's actually 20 minutes slow. Once you get it right there, and the bell should be ringing. After that, she'll crawl out from under there, and you can actually speak to her. So head on over, ask her about Concubine, or Vespers and Compline. She'll explain that she was looking for, was finishing repairs. Ask about Sister Anna, and she'll explain that Anna was supposed to become the next abbess. Ask about the troubadour. And she'll mishear you and say, there's a Minotaur outside? Once you do that, head on back downstairs. We'll go inside the church. Of course, going back downstairs completely, of me being a complete idiot and not noticing that for a moment. Alright, once you're inside, talk to Sister Cecilia. Ask about the Combine. Ask about Sister Anna. And ask about Troubadour. Once you do that, talk to Sister Katarina on the other side. Ask her about Vesper and Columbine. Ask about Sister Anna. And ask about the other applicant as well. And she already knows about the troubadour outside, so don't worry about that. Alright, once you do that, go ahead and go down the stairs and head outside to where Troubadour Valero is at. Or Valerio. I'm sorry, I have a bad pronunciation of some of these. Ask him about the other stuff. There's only 3 clues. He'll explain that he's here because he heard about Sister Anna's death. Where was he between Vesper and Compline? He says he was in Alcarid. Tell him Sister Anna was murdered. Once he does that, head on back in. You can tell Valerio, since he's not part of the order, So go ahead and talk to Benita and say you finished investigating. Huh. Where am I missing? Question suspects? Don't tell me I've missed something. It looks like I need to go speak to him about some more stuff. Okay, I'm going to pause and I'll be right back. Alright, one thing you should do is when you talk to Sister Cecilia, and I'll show you. Ask what are you rehearsing? And ask about the Ripper. And she'll go through saying about that. Ask about if it could come back. Ask if your music can repel demons just for the fun of it. That looks like that's the last of the two clues. Now head back down and talk to Abbess Benita. And you should be able to name a culprit. Say that you finished investigating. Whom do I suspect? To say she killed herself. There was a massive scream. Follow the sound of that scream. You'll be put in a shard instance. So head on over and get to it. Taking the quickest way, you'll end up having to run through the oratory, and it'll say in the chat box where you hear the scream come from. Head down the stairs that was in the room up to where the bell tower was, and in here you'll see blood stains. She'll explain that she saw the Ripper, and it's my time to investigate the stuff. Investigate the bloodstains. Investigate the body. And I think they fixed this during the quest, but at one point, if you could search the reliquary, however you say it, if that was open, you could actually search it, and not wearing enough Ceridolmon based items, you'd get hit your maximum life points minus one. Once here, go ahead and talk to, the sisters, get this part over with. Ask what she saw happen, and once this is all done, she'll examine everything. Ran away. And they'll say they'll trust Ceridolmon, and they'll start back to practicing. Once here, go ahead and head on down to and search the sack at the bottom of these stairs in the kitchen. And you'll find there was a hole in the floor. One thing I did forget to find was there was a cabinet. Come on, character, move. There we go, sorry about that. Head on back down the stairs. I forgot to mention this part. But you search the robe cabinets and find that they were disturbed. You can actually check the rogue cabinet here, and it'll say they've been disturbed. Search it, and you'll find that the rogues are off the hook and crumpled. And it, as it said, that'll explain that there was somebody hiding there. Alright. While I have time, go ahead and talk to Abbess Benita to get the cell key. And she'll give you the key for that. Alright, as she hands you the key, you can go ahead and start searching her cell. Getting around the Abbey is pretty easy, so there's no issue on that. Her cell is the third one. Go ahead and inspect the bed, and you should find a pile of notes. Go ahead and read through them. And the letters are signed Valerio, which means you need to head outside and look for him. Of course, he'll be there, so you just go outside and talk to him. You can also right-click on him and listen, and he'll act just like a regular musician. Go through the stuff about that. Alright, once you do that, go ahead and just talk to Sister Katerina and dance with her. And you'll do the troubadour dance. Once you do that, go ahead and head on back in and talk to Abbess Benita. Before you do that, you do want to tell her about the hole in the floor. Ask about something you found. Secret passage in the kitchen. Okay, and she'll block the passage immediately. I've investigated for now. Whom do I suspect? I'll just choose the Ripper Demon. So go ahead and talk, and she'll send you back outside to fetch Katerina. I do want to go ahead and put a warning now. If you are a minor, please do note that there will be blood violence, and you should have an adult with you for this part. And I ask you that you stop watching now if you are a minor. At least have an adult with you. As you see, she stabbed Katerina and killed her. Once that happens, you'll notice that the gate is down. To open the gate, you need to go up the ladder here on the side and operate the winch. Now, if you notice during the cutscene, that's where they jumped down from. Go ahead and climb down the ladder and talk to Valerio. Once this happens, Abbess, Benita, and Valerio be in the office, I'm going to investigate the body. And you might get some stuff, but there won't be any new updates on that. So next up, they'll ask you to form a plan. They'll ask about the stuff like that. We should lay a trap. They were all associated with Valerio. Alright, at this point, it's up to you to set the trap. Go ahead and pick a cabbage. And head on through the Abbey, or I'm sorry, the Grand Exchange thing. Go ahead and head through the choir area. Pray at altar if you want to, it doesn't really matter. Head on through the choir, head down the stairs. You'll find everything you need down there. In there, you're going to want to move the candelabrum. And you'll automatically set it up. Go ahead and use the cabbage on it. Be sure to use it, not eat it. If you eat it, you can go back and pick another. Inside the robe cabinet, you'll get a set of Cithereid robes. Once you do that, you'll make the said thing. Now it looks convincing enough in the dark. Now you can hide in the robe closet. Hand the rogue cabinet wait, and once this happens, it'll start up the final cutscene. Once this happens, you'll be noticed that the Ripper Demon is a little off point. Then you can knock it out. You don't knock him out and you get attacked. If you get closer than the Ripper Demon, if you can literally catch up to him, you can literally get yourself caught. As you notice, they'll close the door behind them. And then there's the thing where they try to go out the front gate, but then they get notice that the gate is locked. Smart move. Now they'll go back through in the Cithereid's Abbey. She'll have them look at her, that way that the Ripper Demon won't distract them. I like how it just runs right by Abbess Benita and doesn't do a thing. Head up the stairs. Once you go upstairs, you'll notice she has Sister Deborah held hostage. Let her go. Ask who you are. Ask if she can hear the singing. They all loved you. More like the Ripper demon. You're possessed by a demon. Say you're insane. Alright, once that's done, head on down the stairs. Operate the timepiece. Once you do that, set it to the nearest hour. And head on back up the stairs. Thanks to Sister Deborah having very deaf eardrums, she's immune. And as you notice, Sister Deborah took her claws away. Talk to Sister Deborah and saying good thinking. Are you alright? You move pretty quickly. What should we do? And she heads on downstairs. Now it's up to you. Now, here's the option where you get the choice of let her jump off the tower herself or you throw her off. I want to just do the funny part and I'm going to throw her off. You can say, alright, take a moment, and she'll pray, take a step back and fall off. Then there's the option of no, you die now, that's where you throw her off. And I don't want to kill you where she'll fall off anyway. So I'm going to just go, no, you die now. And, I'm going to try to get a good view of this. There we go. And you literally just kick her off. The rest of the funeral procession completes. And pretty much nothing much more than that at the time. Alright, once that happens, you'll be back in Sister Benita's office. And just talk to her. And I should say Abbess, sorry. Who killed it? It was Sister Anna. She was insane. Ha ha. And once all that happens, she'll give you a set of the Cytherine robes, and the quest will be complete. Now, to go ahead and show you something, I'll go ahead and put on the Cytherine robes. And as you see, it offers a plus 19 prayer bonus as a full set. It also does count as a Ceridomen item. I don't know if it counts as an item in the God Wars dungeon. After the quest, you can destroy all this stuff. Alright, and I hope you enjoyed. See you next time.